It looks like someone loved using their tread just a wee bit too much, okay? Hey y'all, I'm Amani.
And I'm Zach.
And today we are diving really, really, really deep into Reddit skincare questions and comments. And apparently there is a lot of talk in the town about tretinoin. So Zach, what is tretinoin?
In the medical community, tretinoin is actually considered the gold standard when it comes to treating acne and anti-aging concerns like fine lines, wrinkles, hyperpigmentation. There's definitely a wrong and a right way to use it. So I'm kind of going to be interested in what they're saying here.
Actually, that's a great segue into our first post. So someone has been asking, have I been using Tret wrong this entire time? This person has been using a thick moisturizer before applying Tret. So their concern is whether or not applying that moisturizer first is canceling out the benefits of using tretinoin.
So tretinoin can be a little bit irritating. It's basically causing a low-grade exfoliation on our skin. So that can cause some dryness. So when you're using tretinoin, you can start by just using it first. So then it's really concentrated. If that's a little irritating, then try putting on a moisturizer first and then applying it. And the other option always is to mix your tretinoin and your moisturizer at the same time and then apply to your entire face. Your moisturizer is not going to cancel it out. It might just dilute the concentration a little bit. You're not blocking it from getting to your cells or anything like that. And it still will do the trick.
Okay, so walk me through it. I have applied my moisturizer, then I'm going to go on my tret. Like, do I need to add moisturizer again? Can I use serums? Like, what do I do?
Yeah, tretinoin can go into your normal routine. So you can use your serum, then you can use your moisturizer, add tretinoin in. Everyone's routine is going to be a little different because it can be irritating for some, and then it also depends on the concentration of tretinoin. There's a lot of different concentrations that you can get, so there's a lot of different options here.
Reminder, this is only at night or daytime too?
Yeah, so tretinoin can be degraded by the sun, so we do say apply this at night before you go to bed.
So apparently I hear that tretinoin is also really good for anti-aging. Is that true?
Yeah, so that's one of its big claims to fame. It basically, as we get older, our skin cells start to turn over a little more slowly, so what tretinoin does is it goes down at a cellular level and helps speed up the turnover process. So it helps kind of clear out fine lines, wrinkles, dark spots, and there's a lot of medical evidence backing this up.
Okay, it all sounds really good, but for this next post, apparently someone got a rash on their body after using Tret.
All right.
So it looks like someone loved using their Tret just a wee bit too much, okay? So they decide to go all in and make a full body slather, okay? Wait for it. Their percentage in Tret was only 0.035%, and they woke up with terrible rashes that looked like flea bites.
Okay, so there's a lot going on in this scenario. You know, tretinoin can be used on your body, but percentages do add up. So you can have a percentage anywhere from like 0.01% up to 0.14%. And it's a big difference, and every patient is very unique on how much tretinoin their skin can actually handle.
Okay.
So you need to be a little careful. The other big thing is at Curology, when we prescribe tretinoin, we only want our patients to use it on their face and neck.
Okay.
When you're using it on the rest of your body, those areas are a little more sensitive to tretinoin, so you can definitely break out into a rash or get a lot of irritation. So you probably want to start with a moisturizer or mix it with a moisturizer before applying to those areas, and probably not use it daily on those areas either. So you gotta be pretty careful.
Okay.
Slathering on is never a good idea. You wanna put on a thin layer and usually mix it with a moisturizer first, for your body at least.
Okay, so the reason why someone would even put tretinoin on their body is because, like, it's also good for anti-aging, so maybe like the back of the hands is a good place to maybe
add
to the body?
100%, okay. So they're all trying to target those areas where you see some fine lines, some hyperpigmentation, age marks, things like that. So they typically hit like the top of their chest and the back of their hands.
Alrighty, so this post says, help, my kid got into Tret and her skin is raw AF. I know. She is 11 years old and she got into her mom's Tret, which is 0.1%. And she says that her skin is super red, irritated, itchy, it's peeling. Like, our girl needs help. What should we tell her?
Oh, yeah. Tretinoin can be really irritating for your skin, and 0.1% is a pretty high percentage.
Okay.
So, you know, the first thing you want to do is get a really good moisturizer on board, even Vaseline at this point, because the skin's probably so irritated. You can also pick up an over-the-counter hydrocortisone cream. You can use it 2 to 3 times a day for up to like 3 days, but after that, I wouldn't use much more hydrocortisone because that can cause its own issue.
Mm-hmm.
It's not getting better. You got to get in to see an in-person provider because I think you should probably have it looked at, especially because they're a younger kid.
Gotcha. Okay, so in terms of just like showering and all that at-home care, would you suggest they take like a warm or hot shower?
They can still take a warm shower. That's not gonna really affect it so much, okay. But you definitely really wanna get a strong moisturizer, a thick, heavier moisturizer, mm-hmm. Vaseline, things like that on board pretty quick.
What about, you know, summertime, trying to be outside? Do we wanna apply sunscreen to it as well? Or like, how should we
Oh yeah,
that?
Once you start using tretinoin in general, sunscreen always has to be on board because you can get a really easy sunburn. Mm-hmm. At this point though, her skin's so irritated that she probably has to hang indoors for a few days until it calms down. Normally it will calm down in like 4 to 5 days, I would hope.
Okay.
But if it's not calming down, you have to go in and see an in-person provider at that point. And on a side note, tretinoin is a prescription medication that you can only get from a medical provider like me at Curology or your local dermatologist or primary care provider.
Sheesh. I don't know, Zach. That sounds like a lot, but there you have it here first, folks. Tret ain't nothing to f- with.
No, it's not.
So if you made it this far in the video, be sure to leave a purple heart in the comments. And while you're down there, if you have your own personal experiences with Tret, if you have any questions that you want to ask us, be sure to ask them. Also, don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe button, and hit that little bell notification so that you do not miss when we upload a new video. Bye. My bad, Zach. Cheers.